Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I just watched an awesome video of the astronauts on the space station passing a football. And apparently the pass was something like 500,000 yards. That's because the space station is of course moving very quickly around the Earth. But it got me thinking, what would happen if the astronauts would have actually done it in the vacuum of space? Now this is something of course that NASA would never try, but I got my 40 liter budget space vessel here. I could give it a shot. So I got the ball inflated to the recommended 9 pounds per square inch. Now that of course is relative to the outside air pressure. The absolute pressure, because the air pressure around it is about 12 psi, therefore is about 21 psi. You see, you got 12 pounds pushing in and 21 pushing out. But if we remove that 12 that is pushing in, what happens to the ball? Let's turn on the vacuum pump and find out. You can see the balloon back there is inflating. That's because the pressure forcing in on the balloon is dropping. And so now the gas that was trapped in there is allowed to expand. Now the balloon can of course increase its volume because it's so stretchy. The ball, however, cannot. So it'll be interesting to see what happens when it finally can't hold any more pressure. So it's been roughly 5 minutes worth of pumping and the ball is still intact. You can see the balloon has expanded quite a lot, but the ball has not ruptured. It looks like the seams might be a little bit stressed, but so far it's been able to handle the pressure. So let's turn the pump off and let's see what happens when I let the pressure back in. The balloon definitely shrank, but the ball, you know, the ball definitely shrank a little bit. It's not like super noticeable or anything though. So this ball probably can actually survive the vacuum of space. But now, let's take this and let's add a little bit more pressure to it. Let's pump it up to around 20 psi, because we've shown that it can handle that. And let's put it in here and vacuum out the air again. So the ball has been inflated to 20 psi relative to atmospheric pressure, which is what it was back when it was inside the chamber. Now, it's a lot stiffer. You know, I'd hate to play with it in this state, but it is still holding together. But let's see what happens when we remove the 12 psi that's holding it together. You know, see if it can handle 30. Let's, it makes a different noise when you hit it on things. We're back under vacuum and the ball is yet to explode. That's actually quite impressive because the relative pressure differential now is about the same as you'd have inside of a car tire. So, this ball's a little tougher than I thought it would be. Of course, I guess it does have to be rather tough to handle being played with on a field. And one thing I'd like to note is the balloon over there. That will never pop even if I put it in a perfect vacuum. You see, the little tiny bit of gas that was there has now expanded so much. You know, the ideal gas law, that the amount of pressure that the gas is forcing on the sides of the balloon is now so little that it can no longer stretch the rubber. So even if the pressure is zero on the outside of the balloon, it still is not going to expand anymore. But yeah, let's try pressurizing this ball a little bit more. Let's try again. So I've now inflated the football to 35 pounds per square inch, and it is rock hard. Like, I can't imagine why anyone would inflate one this much. In fact, I don't really like being around it because it just feels like it might explode. Perhaps someone would accidentally inflate it this much if they were thinking they were inflating a car tire or something, but or perhaps trying to make the opposing team have more difficulty. But I'm gonna say this is probably one of the worst case scenarios, pressure-wise. Let's try it out. Let's see if it can handle the vacuum now. That kind of makes me nervous. It's definitely deforming the ball enough to make it roll around. I wonder if I should like try to push it back before it gets under total vacuum. Oh, it blew up! It actually blew up. Let's turn that off. Woo! So overinflating your ball and then throwing it into space is a bad idea. Now look at this. So you got the rubber inner bladder and then this fabric covering. My guess is the fabric covering was doing most of the, you know, support holding the ball together. There you go. So what must have happened is the stitching was giving way. That's what made it kind of roll around in there. And then the stitching just finally unzipped and the whole thing exploded. The ball wasn't actually in a total vacuum when it exploded. If you look at the balloon was still only kind of rather small. That sort of tells me that the air pressure in there is probably about 1/3 of what it is at normal atmospheric pressure. So that means this ball exploded at just over 40 psi. Kind of gives you an idea of what kind of pressure you could put into the ball and have it explode. You know, this was actually a very dangerous experiment, because if this would have went off out here in the atmosphere, it probably would have hurt me, or it certainly would have hurt my ears and made a loud noise. Inside the chamber, the gas that was in here was able to expand and occupy the space. It was vacuumed, and it never reached a point where the pressure was high enough to burst to the outside. So I'm going to put the video of this exploding at 1500 frames per second towards the end of this video. I hope you enjoy. I'll see you next time.